Hello champions, welcome to another episode of Risk. Today we are playing Capital Conquest with fixed cards on the Europe Advanced map, guys. I'm with 4, the red player in this game, and let's see which capital I can select, guys. What I see is that this continent only has 2 territories in total, and also this territory is in the middle of the map, guys, which makes it unlikely for me to get trapped, and also besides, it kinda separates map. In some ways, I just didn't like what the purple player added their troops here, guys. Maybe they will immediately take that capital if I capture there, guys, but I do not have any good choice otherwise, I guess. Let's try capturing here, guys. Let's send an alliance request to the purple player, guys. Maybe they would like to be friends. And alright, we accept an alliance request. And what in the world, the black player placed their troops in Venice right here, guys. Wow, so many capitals close to each other, guys. I just don't understand why black player did their capital here, because I mean, now they will be without a continent, I guess. Alright, I see that Italy, that Southern Europe in this map only has, well, basically two borders to guard, but with this blizzard being here, the Italian player doesn't have to be worried about getting invaded from the African player. And right here, right, actually this kind of OP setup to the blue player, guys, we could expand. I mean, we could not only expand to West Africa, we could expand to North Africa as well and hold those continents under one border, guys. 1, 2, 3, to hold 3 continents under one border, guys. Wow, that is just insane. So until we reach the white player in the Orient continent, and alright, it will take for one more turn for the green player to capture green. Alright, I will just capture a continent for myself, guys, and I will add troops right here. And alright, let's do that. And I guess I will put 10 troops here rather than 9, because I'm not sure what the black and purple players will do. Well, the purple player has accepted my alliance request, but I'm not sure what about the black player. And the white player sent me an alliance request to me, and I accepted. And yes, attack my territory if you need to. White, attack my territory if you need to. I assume you would like to capture territories in order. Alright, the black player is actually taking over a lot of territories here, guys. Will we consider crushing the purple players? I mean, if the purple player doesn't strengthen their capital. And right here, I guess my next plan is to expand into Southeastern Europe, guys, into this continent right here, the territories of Tenerife, Romania, and Bulgaria. Because as you can see, the white player is going for a continent right here for the Russian Empire, and yeah. Right, 10 troops received by the purple player. What we will do, alright, we might go for Scandinavia, I wanted to see, but no, we moved in here, guys, in Central Europe, and I assume we wipe out the black player behind them. Alright, let's send them a thumbs up, let's send them an heart as well, guys. I mean, the green player might invade them anyway, or if not, then I think we will happily live in peace altogether, guys. So besides, the purple player probably crushing the black player. Alright, let's see if the green player invades the purple here, right here. No, we do not. We just waste our troops right here for some reason, guys. Wow. Right, so in the best position in this game is the purple player as of now, I would say, but maybe not for so long, guys. Who knows, guys? But also a very good possibility to expand here as the blue player, so as long as we keep sustaining a strong position. And right here, should I take over those continents, guys, or should I wait for a little bit? Well, I guess I will try to take them immediately, guys. I think I will take over that continent immediately. Yes, I think that is my plan. Because, I mean, the purple player already captured a second continent for themselves, so I want to get a second continent as well, so I'm just a little bit afraid to leave only 10 troops here, guys. As I know what, if the purple player wants, then we could try taking that capital from me, but at the same time, I see what. If we do that, then the black player could attack them. Whereas a black player is an issue for the purple player, so because of that reason, I might still end up holding my continents right here. And alright, the white player is actually not in that of a good position, guys. Here, and I wanted to see, do we move out from our capital? No, we fortify our troops back, and I guess, and how many troops? 15, alright, 15 troops in total received by the purple player. And let's see what we will do, guys. The blue player wants to have an alliance with me here, guys. I mean, I do not mind, but I mean if it benefits both of us, then it benefits both of us, but if I see that it's favorable for me to attack the blue player, then I will do that. But right here there are stronger players. Anyways, there are strong players. Yeah, I see that the black players going for the black players territories. I didn't see, but I see that they are capturing a ton of territories in general. I mean, that's good because, yeah, if we capture the territories of a white player right here as well, guys, then I assume the white player will get eliminated from the game pretty fast. Alright, so one more territory here, and are you doing mana roll 1 versus 2 mana roll? Alright, we lose that, and sorry. 10 troops received by the green player. Will we expand to Scandinavia? I think this is what I would do if I were them. But alright, we invade the purple player into their continent here, and will we even take it from him? No. Alright, we do not even take that from them, and I guess I would like to just be safe here, guys. I will, alright, 17 troops might be enough. I will strengthen these borders here, and I guess I will capture a territory right here, guys. I will be expanding this way. I will be expanding to Eastern Europe plus 8 troops bonus, guys. And also, I really like what I wiped out the blue player from over here, because we would just be stuck behind the white player, I guess, but I mean, the white player is we, guys, so yeah, maybe the blue player will get very strong, and let's see if, alright, the black player is doing mana rolls on the purple player's army right here. Let's see, I mean, that's probably favoring me, guys, because I might get an opportunity to take over both of those capitals, guys. And maybe not, I mean, the purple player has a turn before me, guys. I think the purple player will take the capital from the black player. And I mean, we will get additional troops for holding our continent, so yeah. Yeah, guys. Alright, yeah, the most potential threat for me is the blue player, guys. We do not have as a great position here, but once we capture West Africa, they will be starting to receive tons of troops. So this is something which is bad. And alright, the white player moves out from over here, and that is something what I like for sure, but I do not like them capturing territories. Yeah, I mean, that doesn't matter to me, that isn't that much of a difference, but I mean, I would like to expand to Eastern Europe by myself, and we probably add all of their troops there, guys. We add all of their troops there. We're doing that split. Let's split on, I guess, if the green player could potentially take over those capitals if he wanted. I mean, if I attack a purple, then I increase the advantage of the green player, or if the green player attacks the purple player, then we increase the advantage of mine, and the purple player has crushed my two troops army. Alright, let's send them a thumbs up, guys. Let's send them a thumbs up, and alright, they send me a heart, so let's send them a heart back, and alright, the blue player is being really aggressive here, guys. Wow, we're being really aggressive. Yeah, I think I should be aggressive as well and potentially take over Eastern Europe if I want to sustain my advantage, if I want. Alright, the white player wants me to attack blue. How do I attack blue? Well, I guess I could add my troops right here, but alright, let's take a look at here, guys. Alright, we green player just takes over. Alright, we want me to attack green. I do not want to attack anyone else. Alright, the white player sends me thumbs down, which is fine, guys. I mean, the white player is a dead player. They will just be eliminated from the game very soon, and right, I guess, let's split my troops like that. I will take some more time before I capture Eastern Europe. And also, I missed the opportunity to eliminate the black player, guys. If he just held those two territories right here, guys. Yes, I even forgot to take a look at that. But I guess we could get eliminated by the white player. Yeah, and the white player will be able to trade on a set, which might or not might use on the blue player. And of course, the white player isn't satisfied that I didn't crush my troops into the blue player, because obviously their destiny depends on the blue player, whether the blue player survives or not here. But alright, the blue player will receive their troops here, guys, and yeah, so I think the white player will lose the game, but we'll see, guys, how that goes here. The black player disconnects right here. We quit. Alright, yes, if the white player gets those god, blitz rolls, I wanted to see we eliminate the black player, but no way. Black player will be still in the game, and let's see guys. So what about the purple player? Will we retaliate to the green player back, or we will just strengthen their positions? Maybe we will just be fine by holding what we hold. And alright, let's see if we do it. Blitz here, guys. Yes, we do. So basically, the green and purple player is taking over each other. The white player is weak, but could potentially be an issue to me, guys, if he got mad on me. And obviously, the biggest threat in this game is the blue player. So yeah, wow. The blue player is getting so strong here, guys. Wow. Alright, what they will do here, guys? They will try blitzing the white player's army. And alright, we get wanted. We get closer here. And alright, we lost 6 troops here, but we eliminate the black player. Will we be able to trade in a set, guys? No, we do not, guys. Wow. Yeah, I'm attacking the blue player as much as possible, I guess. Or I mean, I could eliminate the white player, right, guys? I think yes. I could eliminate the white player and then attack the blue player as much as possible, because the blue player is just taking over too many continents, guys. So I will have to fight them in one or another way anyway. So it's better for me to not let them get that strong, guys. And I mean, if a white player will attack a blue player as well, so maybe then it's worth for me to leave the white player alive, guys. 14 troops. Well, yeah, I mean, I do not have a set. Alright, and let's see if I get a good blitz. 59%. And yes, I make it. And I assume the white player will invade the blue player into this continent if the white player has a set, guys. But maybe they decide to be completely passive, which in this case, that would have been a mistake for me to not invade the blue player into that continent. And yes. Alright, well, at the very least, we might take over Russian Empire, which might force the blue player to invade them into that continent. And I guess I could have fortified rather more troops from my capital to make that capital on Ankara really strong, because I assume the blue player will definitely try to recapture the universe of war between green and purple players. Alright, 24 troops, guys, and we might trade in a set. Alright, that's just a 4 troop set, which is good. Alright. Alright, 25 troops. Alright, that was a really bad blitz, and please fail the 2 versus 1 man roll. And yes, you fail. Wow, guys. Alright. Question is, should I eliminate the white player, guys? I think I should eliminate the white player and then attack the blue player as much as possible. But let's see if I get a good set. Alright, I've got a relatively bad set, 6 troops. But maybe that would be still enough. Guys. Alright, 13 troops is the number of troops the white player has. Plus 8 troops more, guys, here, yeah, I guess. At 4 troops here, guys. At 20. Alright, let's move this army here so to not accidentally block it. And alright, the purple player sends me a hat. Let's send a hat back. Let's use my honor roll, guys, because I want to see any troop here, because if I failed in some way, I will have to waste a lot of troops on the blue players. So yeah. Alright, let's not block my army right here, guys. And let's take out the white player from the game here. At Iris Shiver cuts, guys, and I will trade in an 8 troop set. Yeah, I guess I would rather go after the blue player's continents than their capital here. Yes, I think I will try to invade them into all of their continents here, guys. Yes. I mean, I won't be able to get to the last one, but that is fine as well. Let's just capture additional territories here, guys, because that would be favoring as well. And I also want to keep my capital strong right here, guys, in Vienna, because the purple player might decide to betray me at any time rather than retaliating to the green player back, and the green player might attack me through Scandinavia into my other continents. But let's see, guys. Which players can team up on me if we want. I mean, and or at the very least, the green and purple players could just stop fighting each other. But alright, the purple player fortifies their troops next to the green players. Border, which is good, which makes the tension to be still big. And right here, it doesn't even matter what the blue player does, because I will be targeting them as much as possible. So unless the green player might do something to me, guys. But no, I think that will be still better for me to target the blue player anyway. Yeah. And alright, I will get invaded to that continent, but I will still hold 3 continents, so as long as the green player doesn't invade me. Let's see, guys, what about the green player? Right, we add their troops in Great Britain in London here. Alright, 6 troops, and we'll семьи. Alright, весь ranking where I'm on Scotland as well, but no, we add the rest of our troops in London, and let's see if able to purple play as biggest army, and yes, we do, guys, yeah. We really unnecessarily wasting their troops right here, and will the purple play get invaded into Germany through Denmark, I mean, into Denmark from Oslo, and yes, we do. Yes, we do, so basically, the green and purple players are taking care of each other, and I do not even have to do anything when it comes to them. Alright, I will get 6 troops here, and then right 5 troops here, and yes. Well, I mean, alright, I also got a set, guys. I guess I could be more safe and add 2 more troops here, and the rest of your troops right here. Yes, I will get a really strong position, guys, for sure. Okay, let's wipe out those troops. I will keep some more troops. Alright, the purple player sends me a heart. Let's send them a heart back, guys. I think they're playing for the alliance victory. And alright, attack green. Alright, I will help you out with the green player after I deal with the blue player. And alright, I run out of time to fortify my troops, but maybe it doesn't matter. Alright, the purple player adds their troops here and gets a bad blitz. Gets bad blitz trying to crush the green player's troops in London. And we didn't even get a card. Yes, we didn't even get a cut, guys. Let's see if a blue player has a set, because if he do, we could still invade me, but I hope we get a bad blitz. I hope what we get. Alright, we want 3 troops, which isn't too bad to me. Alright. Yeah, I don't think we can do much, guys. Yeah, I mean, it was up to the green and purple players to help to balance the situation out, but at the very least, those players are fighting each other, but maybe not anymore. The green player attacks me here, guys. Yes. Wow, that is well played by the green player, guys. That is well played. I thought I've got this game so easy for sure, but no, apparently maybe not. I want to deal with a blue player before. I would like to trap them in some way. Well, I guess it isn't really possible. I mean, I still have to invade them into this continent. I will do for this territory, and then I will attack the territories of the green player here as well, guys. Do mon roll, and well, I'm kind of afraid that I will leave my capital too weak, and the purple player might try to take my capital down from me, so this is why I didn't capture extra territories right here. But yeah, guys, if I hold multiple coins in this turn, then I think I will get a good... I think I might be even guaranteed to win this game, and alright, the blue player will invade me, but I hope we get a bad blitz. Alright, we got a good blitz recapturing that 3 troops army, and we got a good blitz recapturing that territory too, and alright, we even invade me into that continent, alright. Alright, 10 troops by the green player, guys. What we will do with these troops? Will they invade me, or we will switch back to the purple player? Right, the purple player sends me a heart, and let's send them a heart back, guys. Alright, let's see, just invade the purple player, and that's, yeah, the green player should just stay passive here. Yeah, I think we should have just stayed passive here, guys. Alright, and let's just wipe out the blue player from over here, guys. Let's and yeah, we'll just leave them there, guys. Yeah, the blue player is sending a crying emote, guys, and yeah, let's send this, guys. All right, the green player will, I assume, will deal with the green player. Yes, we do that blitz here, guys, so yeah. All right, that's nice. I mean, sometimes it's fun to play for the alliance victory, guys. Sometimes you have more fun this way, and I totally understand the purple player here, whether it's their intention or not. And I mean, the green player was targeting them, then we shouldn't have really done so, as we were increasing my advantage. Well played, alright, thanks. The blue player, if you're saying me that, and... Alright, the green player trades in a set. Alright, so the purple player will still be taken care of. Still, I will be dealing with the blue player, and I think I might even put my army in Rabat here, so we would waste their capital troops on my troops. And yeah. And the green player doesn't even invade the purple player into Germany. Or I mean, I could even eliminate the... Alright, I cannot even see how many troops will be in total. 62, alright. And yes, we want to help out with the green player. And alright, I will help out with the green player. Alright, let's help out my ally. My ally purple guys, let's be nice, ally. Let's be a good ally here. And let's see if I get a good blitz. 98%, guys. Let's go. I've got a bad blitz, but I've got barely left with any troops. So yeah. And let's see, maybe the purple player will finish taking the green player out here, guys. And yes, whichever they case as guys we cannot win by capital surrounded because we do not have enough troops. We do not have enough troops for that. And alright, will we eliminate the green player white speak? Yes. Alright, the green player will get eliminated from the games, guys. So apparently the blue player will even get the third place instead of the fourth one. So that was that is lucky for the blue player, but unlucky to the green player. And alright. Yeah, I'm just dominating this game, guys. That's just hilarious. Let's see if a blue player tries doing a blitz here. What will be the case? Alright, a purple player sends me a hat. I send them a hat back, guys. And I will eliminate the blue player. And then I guess I could just take over the purple player's capitals. But maybe I want to take over the entire world, guys. Maybe that will be even more fun if I do that instead. And alright, the blue player finally quit the game. Here, alright, 66 troops here, guys. I will add 17 troops just to be safe, and I will add troops here, guys. A bit more troops here. Even thought it would be better for me to add those troops into one army, but I mean, whatever. Let's eliminate the blue player from the game. I mean, the blue bot. Let's get their cards. The timer is getting reset by 30 seconds, so because of that reason, I should have attacked the territories of the purple player, but I have enough time anyways for that, guys. That's really unnecessary, and I mean, I wanted to stay in a strong alliance with the purple player till the very end. So, alright, let's finish taking over his territories, guys. Let's blitz this capital. Hopefully I do not lose too many troops, but I lost so many troops here, guys. Alright, let's wipe out here. Alright, they send me a hat. Well played. GG. And thank you very much for the game, purple. That was really fun to play with you. I mean, our common alliance. We've got a common alliance victory, I guess. Alright, let's see what their ranks. What were the ranks of my opponents, guys? And a bunch of intermediates and one expert.